Okay, we're back for what is probably going to be the last episode ever, because if I manage to do this challenge that I've been intending, I would have done the hardest thing that I think anybody can think of. So, let's buy beginner's luck, shall we? Sprigatito, yep, you can go up. There can only be one. Yeah, we'll buy that. Right. Okay. Do I have a fixed match card? I do not. That is really annoying. So, here's what I'm going to do. The main event is going to be Transiscan versus Blastoise. No, it's not. Because I need to change. I went trans Blastoise, didn't I? Giant Fighter. And Blastoise is Giant Fighter. So Transiscan is Giant Fighter. Okay. Why did I set them two together then? Was I having a moment of confusion? Probably. Okay, if I can't. Right, okay. Here's what we're going to do. Samus and Joe Hendry have stamina. Right, so here's what we're going to do. We are going to put Samus and Joe Hendry, so prestigious, in a title match in the main event. And it's going to be a tables match, because I believe both of them have a speciality in it. And they do. So, that's good. My women's, it's going to be Leafeon and Lula Tandy. Or it was going to be. However, we are going to have Lula Tandy call her out, which is going to be an absolute freaking disaster. Okay, if we do that, do I have... I don't have a stamina either. Oh, that's really annoying. Okay. Well, we'll use this to try and get some extra fans this week. Right. Okay. The women's tag. We can do that. They are going to go up against Dawn Blitz and Eevee. For the tag. And they're both hurting. Okay, we'll do a tag team call out then. Okay, 4 and a 1, 3 and 3. Okay, we'll have them do that then. Eevee and Dawn are going to go up against the women's champions in that feud. But we do have two specialists there as well. Dynamatrix. Oh! Okay. Okay. We are going to set up a Knight the Bray, thank you for the follow. Okay, so if we set up... if we set up... a tag... Sorry, can I both of the... No. Jake Xanadu and Lucario are going to go together. Download him because he got kicked out, mate. Because of him being a sexual predator and rapist. Allegedly. Along with Vince McMahon for sex trafficking. So yeah, you ain't ever going to see him back in WWE, I'll tell you that right now. I don't bloody know. Download him, I guess. I'm sure there's some in the... I'm sure there's some in the community creations. Last Man Standing, TLC, No Holds Barred. They don't really work well together, do they? Right, well, that's what we're going to do. We'll set them up into a feud, because their popularities are all right. And then we'll have Karen and Mina. Now, we need to end that feud, so that's what we're going to do is the main event. We'll have that as a main event opener. We'll have that there. No, he won't. He will never be back in WWE. Now Trips is running things. Never. It's never going to happen. Vince McMahon puts Brock Lesnar and Roman Reigns down our throats for 8 years and it didn't fucking work. Nobody wants to sit. Nobody with common sense wants to see either of them back. Especially not Brock Lesnar. Feel free, but it's not going to happen. It's literally not going to happen. You know, do you really think that WWE wants to promote somebody now who is so intrinsically linked with Vince McMahon, who is being done for sex trafficking, and somebody who is named in the sex trafficking allegations? They are not going to touch that with a 10-foot barge pole. I'm telling you that right now. It's not happening. It's not going to happen. I don't even need to entertain the idea. It's not going to happen. I'm telling you that right now. It's not going to happen. Probably eventually. I mean, there's nothing wrong against Roman. I think just after, what was it, 3.5 years of Roman being champion, I think that we all need a break from him. Honestly, what I think is going to happen, I think that... what was my shake-up card? Tag Team Rumble. Okay. I honestly think that's never going to happen. But what I think might happen is, as we get towards Survivor Series, so that'd be, what, October, November, I think, whenever they normally have Survivor Series, about that time. Because they normally have Survivor Series around Halloween, don't they? I think what's going to happen is I don't think we will see Roman Reigns before then, but I could see them doing a old bloodline versus new bloodline match, or maybe the current bloodline. So Jacob Fatu, Solo Sikoa, Tongaloa, whatever his name is. So those four against Cody, Kevin Owens, probably Randy Orton, and probably Roman Reigns in a War Games match at Survivor Series. I think that's where they're heading, to be honest. No, I don't think that Jey Uso's no part of the Bloodline story. He's doing his own thing. Jimmy, maybe? But no, I don't think. Okay, Joe Hendry becomes North American champion. 4.5-star match. Doesn't start a rivalry. That's annoying. Okay, we have Lula Tandy and Leafeon in a level 1 rivalry. Brilliant. Transiscan and Blastoise going up against each other. Two giants. Probably not going to be a good match, but Kangaskhan does get the victory. Disappointing. I need to sort their typings out. Okay. The Women's Championship Tag Team feud is at level 1. Jake Zandu, Lucario versus Triton and Hitmonchan. Triton and Hitmonchan get the victory, and it doesn't start a fucking rivalry. Self promo goes up by 6. Bloody hell. And then Kyokujiro and Ignition in a steel cage to end this rivalry against Cinnamon, Garrett and Espeon. Kyokujiro and Ignition get the victory. 3.5-star match. It isn't confirmed, but even an allegation, WWE will want to stay way away from that. Right. You know, when you get into stuff like sex trafficking, then that's just something, as a company that prides itself on PG, they want to stay the fuck away from. And I do think, in my opinion, that I think everybody's sick of seeing Brock Lesnar always being AKA the final boss, and it's like, he's just not entertaining. He's really not. Come in, kick somebody in the balls, F5, Kimura, you're done. He's been doing that for like 8 years, 9, 10 years, maybe even more than that. Because some people think we're their dicks, knights. That pretty much covers it. But yes, oh for fuck's sake. Oh, go on then. His morale's low. Right, we're gonna have to. Yeah, that's fine, Samus. Right. Okay. Promises. What do I have any promises active? That's gonna happen, that's fine. Okay, so I don't need to worry about that. Right, the manage roster. Blastoise is hit level 20. Yay! Right. He's rivalrying with Kangaskhan. Or he should be. Where's Kangaskhan? Tables. Okay. Last man standing or Hell in a Cell. Let's give him Hell in a Cell. Right. They didn't start a rivalry, did they? So... nobody started a bloody rivalry, which is really annoying. I need a fixed match card as well. I really, really need a fixed match card. Jesus. Right, okay. Right, we'll do another self promo for Midnight. Actually, we could have Midnight just call somebody out. We could have Midnight call out Cinnamon Garrett. Yeah, why not? Let's do that. Actually, I could just put them in a match. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. Midnight and Cinnamon Garrett. That's who you're fighting. Good morning, Ginger. Actually, what are their specialities? False count anywhere and last man standing. Let's give them a last woman standing match. I'm alright. Still waking up, if I'm honest with you. Right, we're going to have Lula Tandy call out. Actually, no. I'm going to have Leafy on, because she's a better promo, call out. And she'll still gain stamina. Okay, if we do... Samus calling out Joe Hendry. Because they are going to feud, whether this game wants them to or not. And we're going to have... Right, let's have the women's champions call them out now. Because they really need stamina. Okay, and then this brings us to... Right. Health spa. Okay. Right, okay. I'll give that to Joe Hendry. And then what we'll do is we'll have Karen and Mina in the main... yeah, fuck it, we'll put them in the main event. She is still pretty popular. So, let's make it a triple threat. Let's put Springer Tito in there as a specialist to try and even it out a little bit. And then we could put Espeon in there as well. Fuck it, why not? Actually, we could put Jiro in there. Jiro and Espeon? No, we'll keep Sprigatito in there because she's got higher star power, I guess, even though she ain't that popular. Right. 4500, 6, 7, 49. Let's make that a tables match. Which is Sprigatito's speciality, actually. Well, what's the commissioner got? I'll have at least one steel cage match. Oh, yeah. Busting my ball strips. Right, okay. Right. Right, okay. That is really frustrating. Right. Oh, Lucario is off as well. Darn. Okay, we'll scratch that. Okay, that works. And then we'll have the women's tag. Do I have a pre-match physio? I do. Right, we'll give that to Dawn. Where is she? There she is. Right. Let's make it for the championships. Why not? Why don't we do right? If I turn Kangaskhan into a fighter, I need more promo slots, damn it. Right. Fuck it, we'll end that feud in the steel cage. Give Trips what he wants. Dewey can't us back there. This is not going to be a great show, but it doesn't matter, I've got the money. Karen, Mino, Shido, Sprigatito and Espeon. Sprigatito gets the victory, good for them. Compacto and Ashido goes to level 3. Leafeon and Lulatandi goes to level 2. Midnight, Cinnamon, Garrett in the last woman standing match. Midnight gets the victory. And it starts a rivalry. I will take that. Let's write that down. Midnight versus Cinnamon Garrett. And that is a level 1 rivalry. Not great, but it's started one at least. Okay, finally we've got a rivalry between Samus and Joe Hendry for the North American Championship. Okay, good. Dawn, Blitz and Eevee go up against the Doms. And they get the victory, new tag team champions. And that goes to a level 2 rivalry. There we go, there's the men's tag. Except I still haven't got them. I still don't have that title in those titles in that feud because I don't have a fixed match card. Arcus the Great beats Adrian in a 4-star match. You know what? I will happily take that. Thank you, gentlemen. Four-star match for a 3-star feud. I'll take it. Oh look, they've got Beth Spartan and May May Maple over there in a rivalry. Carrie Rush cutting a promo, Toga cutting a promo, Mount Lady cutting a promo on Carrie Rush. NXT 2.0 still have CM Punk going up against Bray Wyatt, Nicholas Mann cutting a charity promo, Snorlax cutting a charity promo, Clay Courtman being called out by the world NXT 2.0 heavyweight champion Rikishi. Mighty Kirk teaming with Blair Davenport to go up against Candice LeRae and Indy Hartwell. WCW, still with only one local talent, and that's Rich Arakawa, who is calling out the TV champion? I'm not quite sure what that WCW belt is. Might be the World Heavyweight, I'm not sure. Okay. 3, 2, 2.5, 4. That's okay. Okay, five challenges. So we've got our eighth Hall of Fame try. Oh, what a veto champ! And an injury rehab as well. That's good for us. So we are 233,276 fans away from our ninth Hall of Fame trophy. Sorry, Tryon. Right. Argus the Great has a new perk, and it's a fighter or bruiser. Well, I only have one giant bruiser. Two, if you count Dwaggienite, but he's a bruiser giant. I already have three giant fighters in Blastoise, Transiscan, and Triton. So we'll make him a bruiser. Not that it's probably going to matter, to be honest. Okay. Why are you grumpy? You literally won a steel cage match, dude. You won your rivalry. Cheer the fuck up, motherfucker, or I'll fire you. The firings will continue until morale improves. Right. Right. Oh, we got somebody else with a perk. Adrian Williams. Basic popularity. Yeah, we'll do that. I mean, his stamina's fucking god-awful now. Right. Leafeon and Luda Tandy can have a singles match. And we'll make it for the Women's Championship. Now it could be the main event. Let's try and increase that rivalry up a little bit. Then we're going to do a class change for Blastoise. Which is going to turn him into a fighter. A fighter giant rather than a giant fighter. And then we could, to try and get the types working, we could put Dwaggie in that feud to go bruiser, because he's a fighter. Blast is a fighter, Dwaggie's a bruiser. Then we would need a fourth that's a cruiser to kind of go up against Transiscan. Unless I change Kangaskhan as well. Make them both fighters. Right, let's work this out. Okay, if we have Joe Hendry calling out Samus, right, get schooled. Is Dwaggie 25 yet? No. Well, this is going to make him 25 in immortal, so that's going to really, really help. Gain the Superstars GM power card the week after each PLE. The superstar's stamina is set to 65 at the start of every season. That's a morale booster, that is. That's a I've never seen that, but that's a really, really good card. Raises morale. That's not going to help me in the rest of the season, simply because this is probably going to be the last season. So, after week 20, I will get that power card. So I might as well do that. If for some reason I can't get to 10 Hall of Fame trophies, that will work all next season as well. So that's going to work. Right. Hitman-chan. Okay, if we cast... I've literally got one person on my male roster that's a cruiser. I could put Clint McDougall in the picture. There's a fatal four-way. Okay. That is what I'm going to do. So let's try and get these titles off of them. So they are tables specialists, so we don't want a tables match. It's going to be a title match, but it's going to be against the two faces. No, it's not, because it's freaking new character. Right. Oh, fuck. I really need a fixed match card. Tell you what, I'm going to veto one of WCW's champions, because they've done it like three times to me. I'm going to use another network special, because I can't use it in a PLE week anyway. We're going to use a Superstars GM card. Right, who am I going to be using? We've got Hitman-chan coming up. Let's use it on Dawn? Actually, no, let's use it on Leafeon, because she's a women's champion. She needs that. There we go, she's super happy. Right. I don't have any injured people. Well, that's good, I guess. Right. If I'm not doing the women's champions this week, let's give that to them. Right, Midnight can go into a match with Cinnamon Garrett. No, she can't, because she's at 33. Okay, that feud can tick along then into the last sequence. Right, so if we do... Lucario needs his fucking personal time. Right. Oh, they're faces. I thought they were heels. Okay, we'll make it a title match then. It's not going to work very well, is it? No Holds Barred and Hell in a Cell are both extreme, very high stamina cost, aren't they? Oh, cock it. If I do that, that's going to knock them out, but that would mean we could put the tag feud in, assuming that they win. Okay, I'm going to hope that they can get the victory there. That should be main event, shouldn't it? If it's Hell in a Cell. Right, if we make an Extreme Rules match, it won't injure Leafeon, but it will lose her stamina. But it's probably going to transport the title onto Lula Tandy, which should raise her popularity up a little bit. I hope. Right. Then we've got Blastoise is changing his role, so he would at least be able to feud with Dwaggie, and we'll put Trans in the title picture as well. But we've got nothing for Kyokajiro. Right, here's what we're going to do then. We are going to put Espeon could be a bruiser. I have to wait for that, I think. Right. 37. What's Mina Ishido's 2? Okay, no, they're busy. Okay, right, here's what we're going to do. Simon Gary's not busy, but she's risking it. Right, okay, you know what, let's put Sprigatito in a match. Let's put her in a match with Espeon and Jiro. Just give them something to do. Three specialists. Probably not going to work very well, is it? We've got Ignition there as well. I don't have anything for either. Oh, Jesus, this is not going well. Right, okay. Keep that there just for a second. I do have a pre-match video. If we put that on Espeon. This is me struggling to fill out the card. Okay, Midnight Cinnamon Garrett, please don't get injured. And then we'll have a self promo for Jake Xanadu, I guess. Actually, can we make that a last woman standing? No, we can't. Well, I've got an injury rehab if somebody gets injured. Extreme Rules, Leafeon and Lula Tandy. Lula Tandy, new champion. 4-star match. Doesn't increase the rivalry. Okay, Blastoise turns to a fighter. Midnight and Cinnamon Garrett. Cinnamon Garrett gets the victory. Level 2. Good, she's not injured. Good, 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 good. Joe Hendry calls that Samus. Grows to a level 2. Normal Fatal 4-way match. Kyokajiro gets the victory. A disappointing match, but I suppose that's what you get when you get four specialists. But we got a Sprig Espeon feud, which I guess we can work with. We get Tito versus Espeon. Level 1. Come on, Jake, you're a primary skill of 5. Right, come on, change the titles. God damn it! Rikishi defending his title against Nicholas Mann. Come on, Nicholas! Two, 1.5, 4. What happened to Dwaggie Longtail? Been MIA. Yeah, tell me about it. Right. Contract negotiation. Oh, that's not really very helpful. Dude, you're in a world title picture. Blastoise, you're in the world title picture. You carry up like that, you're going to be getting your P45. Right. Who's a male face? Okay, we'll put him in there to make the numbers right. Extreme Rules, pre-match physio. Ugh, fuck it, why not? Titles on the line, Extreme Rules match. Adrian Williams is probably gonna get fucked. But it doesn't matter because I have an injury rehab. Right. Lucario and Jake Xanadu. Joe Hendry can call out Samus again. Right, okay. Pretty much physio, beginner's luck, get schooled, right, get schooled, can go on to Triton, because I think that might put him up to 20. It did, fantastic. Right, so Triton's going to have a new perk. Last man standing or TLC? Ooh, well he's in a tag feud, so TLC would be better. Right. Right, contract negotiation, I have none of that. Beginner's luck, it's Brigantito, okay. Right. Okay. I have a lot of hurty people. Lula Tandy is high stamina and she's 24. Right. I mean, if we do that, that's going to have to push it through to... that's going to have to actually push it through to WrestleMania. Mina Ashido's at 68. Okay, you know what? You two can have the main events. Because you're actually more popular for some reason. Okay. Karen and Mina Ishido, you can have the main event. hopefully that'll go to level 4, because that is the go home angle. Midnight at Cinnamon Garrett. Cinnamon Garrett, where are you? You're at 26. Oh, everybody's hurting. Right, women's tag. I might have to trade some people after the pay-per-view, you know, because I don't think they're going to have stamina up. And that's going to be a right pain in the backside. Right. Kyokajiro, you can go up against... hurting. I should not book that Hell in a Cell. Okay, you three show what you can do in a triple threat. It's gonna suck because they're all faces. Oh, let's put Espeon in there as well. Four specialists. This is really gonna suck. This is not a good go-home show. Dwaggie's the new champion. Agent Williams is injured for 4 weeks. And they've got the world title feud. Okay, so it's Dwaggie and Adrian Williams for the world title feud. Going into Mania, it looks like, because that's a level one. Right. That has thrown a sizable wrench into my plans. I did not foresee that result happening. That's a level one, but Adrian is injured. But I do have an injury rehab. Actually, I think I've got like three. Okay, Joe Hendry's called out Samus, which brings that to a level 3. Women's tag. The Doms get the victory. Goes to a level 4 feud. Okay. Okay, the men's tag goes to level 2. Specialists. Springer Tito gets the victory again. Springer Tito is level 2 with Espeon, and Jiro goes with Ignition, which is a level 1 feud. Kyokajiro versus Ignition. They're two faces, so I'm not sure how it's going to work. I might have to turn one of them at the pay-per-view or something. Right. Lulatandi and Leafeon goes to level 3. Karen Compact at Amina Ashido. Karen gets the victory in the go-home angle. It goes to level 4. Mount Lady going up against Carrie Rush. Mighty Kirk calling out one of the tag team champions. Not quite sure that's what you want to do, a singles feud with your tag team champion. But okay, what the hell do I know? I'm only number one. Right. Not sure how long a blast will... Well... If Blastoise leaves, then that's on him. He didn't start a feud with Kangaskhan. That's his fault. Sorry, Transaskhan. Popularity 54, he's a fighter. I could have him and Argus the Great going to a feud. Oh, for fuck's sake. Hitmanshan has the flu. On the pay-per-view week. Okay. Right, what are the power cards? Fixed match, finally! Oh, it means we'll be able to get the bloody tag belts off them. Right, main event is going to be... Karen Compactor. In a fatal four-way with Mina Ashido, Leafeon and Lula Tandy for the World Women's Championship. And we're going to make that... a tables match because that is the pay-per-view thing. Right, so we're going to do a pre-match physio on Leafeon though because I don't want her getting injured. Right. Now. We are going to have Joe Hendry, local hero, going up against Samus in a fatal four-way. With Blastoise and Argus the Great, because if Argus the Great and Blastoise start a feud, I can turn Argus the Great into a bruiser. I would have thought Last Man Standing would have been the Survivor Series speciality, but what the hell do I know? But apparently it's tables this week. Okay, right, women's tag team champ. What's the commissioner goal? Blinded, I don't need that. I've got that. Career. If we get another, I'm going to have that by the end of the season, so that'll be that. And if I get another 157,000 fans, and, well, 157 and 28... I'll get another Hall of Fame trophy. So I'm pretty much guaranteed to get the 10 Hall of Fame trophies now. So, women's tag for the title, and it's going to be a TLC match. Could make it steel cage, actually. Do any of them have specialities in steel cage? Donna Matrix does. So, you think you're untouchable? Word life. So, blah. Think you're untouchable. Word life. Right, so we can yank the tag team titles off of the regular. Right, we can't have Hitmanshan go up against it. So, what we could do, we could have Triton Hang on, let's try it in team with Hypnotize. Okay, so we want Jake Xanadu. Where is Jake Xanadu? There he is. Right. And then we'll do an injury rehab on Adrian Williams. There you go. I'm sorry that you're injured. My fault. Injury rehab. There we go. So now he's fully healed. Okay. Oh, I've only used one this week. Okay. Right. Okay. World title, Dwaggie and Adrian Williams, right. Well, Dwaggie's going to have to call out Adrian then. Sprigatito, we need you to have a good showing. Cinnamon Garrett. Yeah, okay, we can put you on the card. Last woman standing match. Morale to winner, morale to loser. That'll work. Okay. In a position. So that might allow Midnight to get the victory, which should raise her up a little bit. And then if we do... Kyoka Jiro and Ignition... We really need a heal in there, don't we? Christ. Okay. She's probably going to get injured. But I do have another injury rehab card, don't I? Yes, I've got two. So if she does happen to get injured, we can deal with that. So, we are going to do a self-promo for Triton. And we're going to do a... Well, I could role change Transit Scan, couldn't I? Oh, we could have Trans and Clint go into a feud, actually. What's Trans's other type fighter? What's Clint's? Bruiser. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. We're going to class change Clint McDougal, and then eventually we'll roll change Transit Scan, so it's going to be Bruiser Fighter. That's what we're going to do. So Clint is now going to go to a Bruiser Specialist. And that, I think, is the show. Oh, that... Hang on. Wait. Men's tag we can't do. World Championship we can't do. If I do that, they're going to get really hurt, aren't they? Right, I did have a last man. Okay, we'll do that. So if we do that, that's going to get a higher rank rating. So if we switch that around, we'll put that there with that. And that would work. Checked our power cards. I haven't done a fixed match. I could do a fixed match. I mean, if Blastoise wins this, I could have Karen come back, and then we could do a Karen Leafy on the feud, couldn't we? You know what? Decided, I'm going to have Karen win that one. And we'll save the other fixed match card for the tag team title transition. That's what we're going to do. Did I have a TLC match? I didn't. Well, we'll save that card for WrestleMania then. Right. Here we go. Last woman standing should be at least a 4.5 star. Midnight gets the victory. 4.5 stars. Perfect. Midnight and Cinnamon Garrett goes to a level 3 rivalry. Men's tag feud, which will have the belts on it eventually, goes to a level 3. Ignition, Kyokujiro, Springer, Tito and Espeon, 4 specialists. Springer Tito gets a victory again. Springer Tito and Espeon goes to 3. Jiro and Ignition goes to 2. Disappointing match though. Okay, Dwaggie calls out Adrian. That goes to level 2. I really need to get some health spars. Maybe one of the shuffles will help me. The shake-ups, rather. Women's Tag Team Championship match. The Doms get the victory. Which means the Doms are still Tag Team Champions. Tron cuts herself. Promo goes by 2. It could have been better. Normal fatal four-way match for the World North American Championship. Blastoise does indeed get the victory. Samus is out for 2 weeks. Hendry and Samus rivalry ends. Blastoise did not start a feud with Argus. That is annoying. But it is literally a booking book of booking. Show you it in a second. So it's going to be Blastoise versus Argus the Great going into Mania. Here is the booking book of booking. See, there's the booking book of booking. You can see me literally, I've written down who I've got. I've been writing down the feuds. I'm writing down what their types are and their heel and face alignments are. See, it is literally a booking book of booking. Yeah, I've done the Perfect Ninja Painter one. Oh, I didn't see Dark Gems. I'll have to do that shortly. Oh, and Happy Buster Die as well. Bloody hell, there's a lot coming out. Well, guess I'll be doing that today then. Right. Yeah, the game where you literally do nothing. Right, Clint McDougal is now a brawler and he was going to fight with Kangaskhan, wasn't he? So I'm going to write that down. Clint McDougal versus Transascarn. Yeah, I have a transsexual Kangaskhan in this failure. She had a sex change, and he wants to do now is look after his son, and so he does. Trans pride. Okay, and the final event of the evening, the main event, a tables fatal four-way between Karen Compact, Amina Ashido, Leafeon and Luda Tandy. Karen Compact is going to get the victory. And it's a double rivalry ender. So I don't know what the next feud is going to be. Karen versus Leafeon, I think. Because their types do match up. So that's what the next feud is going to be. As we go into Mania. SmackDown are having an ambulance match. between Mount Lady and Carrie Rush. Okay, I'm intrigued. Carrie Rush puts Mount Lady in an ambulance. Mount Lady is out for 3 weeks. Bloody hell, Carrie Rush. Good for you, girl. Good for you. NXT 2.0, we've got Clay Courtman in a World Championship Fatal 4-Way with Rikishi, Giovanni Vinci, and CM Punk. What's the bet in CM Punk's going to get injured? Because he always gets injured because he's a brittle, bitter old man who thinks he's better than he actually is. Right. WCW have Rich Arakawa in a non-title tag match, teaming with, I believe that's Jimmy Uso, against Sami Zayn and Kurt Angle, because why not? And they have a world championship match between Yokozuna and Eddie Guerrero. God, if they could have fought each other in each of their primes, that would have actually been a very intriguing match to watch. Right. Okay. Oh, we are just shy of the 9th Hall of Fame trophy for 7 million fans. Okay. Right, let us work out. Okay, so Dwaggie and Adrian Williams are going to be in the WrestleMania card. Karen and Leafeon are going to be in the WrestleMania card. Blastoise and Argus the Great have a feud planned. Triton, Hitman-Chan, Jake Xanadu, and Lucario. Triton, Jake Xanadu, Lucario, and Hitman-Chan have a planned feud. Pretty Ruthless and Donna Matrix, the Doms, are the tag team champions, and I don't have anybody for them yet. Sprigatito and Espeon are in a level 3 feud. Midnight and Cinnamon Garrett are also in a level 3 feud, I think. Yes, they are. Kyokajiro and Ignition are also in a feud. So, if we have Lula Tandy You have Lula Tandy team with Evie. For a tag. That could work. Where's Lula Tandy? Okay, that's what we're going to do. So if we have Lula Tandy and Evie, this is like Evie's third tag team partner. I think they were with May 1st, then Dawn, and now Lula. Evie really needs a trainer, don't they? Right, okay. Which means I have nothing for Midnight. Oh, I do have something for Midnight, that's Cinnamon Garrett. Which means I literally have nothing for Dawn. Was I going to do something with Transascar? I was going to be Blastoise, but now it's going to be Argus the Great, I think. Who's more popular? Trans or Argus? Okay. If we do Blastoise Kanga. No. We can't. Argus is going to need to change. Okay, so I've got nothing for the Transiscan. Okay, so where's Trans? Right, put them up. Okay, you know what? I've got nothing for Kyoko Jiro other than that feud. So let's get rid of Kyoko. Let's get rid of Ignition. Where's Ignition? Let's get rid of them and their feuds. Let's get rid of Espeon. Actually, we'll keep that because she's 62. 74. Ugh. We could do call-outs, I suppose. Right. Eevee isn't that popular, though, is she? Right, let's condense some of these feuds. If we go... I don't have anything for Joe Hendry. Am I seriously considering getting rid of Joe Hendry? If we turn Dwaggie face... And I could get rid of Clint McDougall here, and then we would have, the tag team championships where they need to be, and I don't need Clint McDougall at all. If I get rid of Samus as well, get rid of all five of them. Let's do some maths. 108, 132, 2. 187 to 270, 226 to 226, 920. Would you give me, who's got the most? He does, right. Would you give me 200 grand for all five of them? Since you do commonly injure your stars. Actually, do you have any local... You do have Maya T. Cook there. No stamina, though. Snorlax is there as a giant. Eh. Nicholas Mann is there as a fighter. Right, let's just chop them from the roster. Yes, okay. Five off the roster. Right, so Transiscar. Transiscan is gone. Where is my black permanent marker? Right, Transiscan is gone. Kyoko Jiro is gone. This is me getting ready for Mania. This is... Okay, Ignition is gone. Clint McDougall is gone. So that means I can just immediately put... I've basically given him both of my tag champs. Samus is gone. I've probably made a mistake here, but I don't know what it is. Could have asked for more. I mean, I think I asked for about what they were worth, to be honest. Right. What's WCW got? Rich Arakawa. Okay, what championship is that? Ah, the United States Championship. I forgot WCW had one of those. Didn't the US Championship originally come from WCW? I think it did. Because WWE had Intercontinental Championship. Himiko Toga's there. You know what? I don't think I have anything else. I'm good. SmackDown are offering me Mount Lady and Nikki Cross for Evie. I would, but I can't take Nikki Cross because of the rules. And I can't take them because of the rules. Sorry, but I still can't take him because of the rules. I know you've added 15 grand, but I just can't take him. WCW offering me Gunter for Argus the Great in 20 grand. I would normally take that because Gunther, but I literally can't because of the rules. But that is, I would actually take that if I was playing normally. Karen, didn't you... You ended that feud, honey. You ended the feud. Feud's over. It's done. Yep. Mina, you're in something different now. That's completely fine. What you're going to be doing, I have no idea. Actually, what are you doing? So I was going to do Clint versus Trans, but obviously I don't need to do that now because I got rid of them. Right. Let's see what our shakeups are going to be. All of your specialist superstars gain +3 mic skill. Select a superstar with a... That'd be great if I hadn't just got rid of 4 fucking specialists. Select a superstar with a mic skill of 1 to change their mic to 5. I mean, if we're gonna have Karen and Leafeon go at it, they need stamina. I could have really used some stamina boosts here. That's only going to give me 5,000 fans. That's barely a charity promo. So I might as well do this. There we go. That card is thanks to Dwaggie. Right. Your least popular available fighter. Who is that? My least popular available fighter is going to be Hitman-chan. That's fine. Right, we are going to crown some new tag team champions. And it's going to be... Right, no holds barred, TLC, Hell in a Cell. None of them... Actually, we could do a TLC match. That's what we're going to do. TLC match, that's going to be the main event. And then they can heal... Ready for the next feud. Right. Adrian Williams. Right, Dwaggie is going to call out Adrian Williams. Adrian is going to do a self promo. Because his promo is now up to 5. So that should really help. And we were going to have Blastoise go against Argus the Great, who needs to do a role class change, so he's a bruiser. And then we're going to have Mina Ashido What's Lula Tandy's other type? Giant. And I've just thought, yeah, because I got rid of Samus and... We'll get that just for the casket. We'll do a casket match at Mania, why not? Right. Okay, who's miserable? You shouldn't be miserable. You're fucking highest popularity, dude. I've been giving you a push. What the fuck, Tryon? Donna Matrix not very happy. I should probably give her it because she is a tag team champion. Right. Okay. And let's save that till WrestleMania. Right. Okay. What am I going to do with Joe Hendry? Didn't I say I was going to turn him? I've completely forgotten what I was going to do with Joe Hendry. Oh, he was going to fight Dwaggie, wasn't he? Yeah, he was going to put himself in that feud. Or was I going to... Okay, we'll scrap that for now. We'll do a role change. Sorry. Yeah, it is a role change for Joe Hendry. He can come back and be face again. God, everybody is hurting. Right. Sprigatito can have a match with Lulatandy. Simply because she has stamina, and that's literally the only reason. God, everybody's hurting. Okay. Mina Ashido and Dawn Blitz. Don't get injured, Dawn, please. Oh. Umbreon's there. Blaziken's there. No point getting Blaziken at 27 popularity, but Umbreon at 54 will bring her in. Umbreon, come back. We need you. And a promo skill of 5 as well. That really helps. She's a face... Bruiser Giants. That might actually help me. Out of all those, I mean, I could get Blaziken and Carolina Reaper, but I have no use for them. Right. Let's put do that. Right, we'll cancel that just for now. We'll have a tag team call out because I need that. The Doms are going to call out Lula, Tandy and Evie to try and start that rivalry up. And then we'll have Midnight and Cinnamon Garrett and hope they don't get injured. Let's go. Actually, I could play Blinded on someone. Yeah, fuck it. Let's play it on SmackDown. Right. Confirm booking. So, tables match. Brigatito and Lula Tandy. Lula Tandy gets the victory. Tag team call out. Okay, level one. Mina and Dawn Blitz. Literally a throwaway match. Just to fill up the card. Dawn gets the win. She's going to be injured, isn't she? Starts the level one rivalry. Well, we can come back to that, maybe. Joe Hendry is now face. Midnight and Cinnamon Garrett don't get injured. Midnight gets the victory. Level 4. Okay. Argus the Great is now a bruiser. And a TLC tag team match to declare the new tag team champions. And it's Lucario and Jake Xanadu. 4.5-star match. Goes for a level 4 rivalry as well. Kangaskhan straight into a tag team feud there. Sorry, Transaskhan. Trans Pride. 2-2, 2.5, 4.5. Huh, NXT 2.0 bought Transaskhan and Kyo Kajira from NXT. Okay, so we're about to get our 9th Hall of Fame trophy. Possibly our 10th. 9th. We have got the 10 Hall of Fame trophies. We now need to just keep a hold of first. As long as no one else gets the other 3 Hall of Fame trophies, we will have successfully done the Impossible Jobbers Only Challenge. Officially. We now have our 10 Hall of Fame trophies. I literally just brought you back, honey. Right. Anyone else with perks? No. Right, power cards. Get schooled. Oh, thank God, a health bar. Thank God. Right. Well, we got get schooled as well. I didn't see those. Okay. Let's give it to... Who's probably going to get another perk? Karen Compactor. Yeah, okay. She's got an extra perk. Right, get schooled. Where's the other one? Well, that's going to give 15. Let's give that to Donna. Because that'll get her over the next level. Right, let's deal with those 2 perks. Karen Compactor. Ambulance or Steel Cage. You know what? We hardly ever do ambulance matches. Let's do an ambulance match at WrestleMania. Let's go fucking crazy with them. Donna Matrix, tables or ambulance? Well, she's going to be in the tag feud, so we'll do tables. Right. Joe Hendry's win loss 19-9. Not bad. Jake's Island lose 4-15. Karen Compactors 14-13. 1-2 for Triton. Cinema Garrett's 4-9 to bloody hell. Well, she, at least she's happy. Leafions is 6-5. Blastoise 7-14. Lucario's 10-8. Not bad. Dwaggies is 15 evens. Espeon's is 10 evens. Mino Shido is 2-10. Donna is 13-9. Dawn. I don't have any. Lots of wins on this, do I? Must be because of the multi-man matches. I bet that's why. Have I put? I don't think I've put Sprigatito in 18 matches. Unless it's counting the ones from previous seasons, which is possible. Right. Okay. I did promise Umbreon a match. So who are we going to put her up against? Thank you, Faye. That's very good to know. I will get to those after I've done this last episode. Umbreon is a bruiser. We can't put her up against Cinnamon Garrett. We can't put her up against them. Why don't we put you up against Sprigatito? And we'll have a run-in by Espeon on Sprigatito. Because that's who they're feuding with. So it's like a three Pokemon event. That's what it's going to be. And we'll make it a tables match. For funsies. No, not tag team. Singles, there we go. Tables run-in. There we go. Actually, it's no DQ in tables match. Just put it in the opener. Right. Joe Hendry is going to go into a match with Dwaggie. Would help. Actually, is Adrian back? Adrian's back. Let's. Okay, we'll do Dwaggie and Joe Hendry. We'll have a self promo. Actually, no, we'll have a call out promo by Adrian. We've got 2 weeks. We'll have him do a self promo. We'll do a self promo for Leafeon. No, I need you and Karen to call each other out. Then we've got Argus, who is supposed to go up against Blastoise, who is vetoed this week, which is a giant pain in the butt. Okay, we've got Midnight there. Cinnamon Garrett is needing health. We could do the women's tag, couldn't we? Not really. I'm really struggling to put matches together because of tiredness of my roster. Vetoes don't help as well, yes. Why don't we do Lulatandy? Why don't we make it a triple threat tables match? We'll put Lulatandy in there as well. And then we'll do. Everybody is hurting. Okay. Let's see if I can find some more people. Kami Tsushima is there. That's an option. Right now, she might actually be my only option. Kami at Sashimi is there with stamina. Right. Well, guess she's coming aboard then. Kami at Sashimi, who is a heal fighter specialist. We are really, really struggling to put a card up going into WrestleMania with the feuds that I intended. Right, Kami can go up against Mina Ashido. I'm not going to do a run-in. Not me, nicely done. There we go. Have at least one last man stand scouted. Useless. Okay, I've got a health spar. Who's the lowest and who do I need? I'm going to... Okay, if we rest Triton, let's see, they gain 12 each week that they're not used. 35, 49, are we ready for the pay-per-view? If we use Cinnamon Garrett for that... Okay, that's what we're going to do. Right. It's a weak show. I'm not going to lie. I mean, they're both good at tables match. Let's make that a tables match. Put the title on the line as well. Why not? Make it a triple threat feud. Tables match. Espeon running in. Umbreon gets the victory. 2.5 stars. Adrian Williams gets 5. That's good. Mina Ashido and Kami. Kami gets the victory. That starts a feud. Huh. Okay, we can deal with that. Mina versus Kami. And she is a level 1. Come on, Leafeon, you're a level 5. Midnight and Eevee. Midnight gets the victory. Disappointing. You're a world champion and the most popular woman on my roster. You are a level 5 promo. You had 2 callouts and neither of them worked. Is this some sort of protest? Probably. Joe Hendry becomes the new NXT champion. Let's add versus Joe Hendry into that triple threat. Snorlax and Akira Tozawa are going in an ambulance match. Oh, this I have to see. Akira Tozawa has somehow got Snorlax in the ambulance. I'm just going to assume that Snorlax saw the bed and thought, yeah, that's a good place to nap. That's what I'm going to assume. And he's not injured, he's just going to be sleeping for 3 weeks. That's my headcanon, okay? Two and a half, 2, 1.5, 4.5. I'm curious if... Clay Cutman didn't win. Never mind. Joe Hendry is such a natural at being a good guy. Well, all you've got to do is believe in Joe Hendry. He appears. We believe in Joe Hendry. So we're still in the lead. 2 weeks until WrestleMania. Argus the Great. Do I have him in a feud? I do with Blastoise. Yep, you can have 100,000. That's completely fine, Sprig. Ensure that Karen Compactor cuts a promo. I gave her a promo last week and she did jack shit with it. Okay, if I wait till Mania, I could buy that. That's going to be better for the fans gained. So I'm not going to buy that this week. Right, Talent Scouts. Silence is there. Power cards. Special guest. Well, I guess that looks like what we're having. Right, let's... Okay, no rivalries. Beginner's luck. Cammy. Right. So we are going to have at Mania a casket match, a TLC match, and a special guest referee match, apparently. Right. Mina and... Nope. Okay. Let's go by who's got stamina. Umbreon has stamina. Right. Blastoise and Argus. I need you to call each other out. For the love of God, please do something useful with your lives. And Karen Compactor needs to call out. God, they're not even in a bloody feud. And it's week 23. Women's tag we can do. Cinnamon Garrett we can do. This is really... I'm really struggling. Right. We'll put that in a last woman standing match. We'll put that there. What's the commissioner goal? Ensure, okay. What am I even doing that for? A back alley crew. Yeah, well, hang on. Can't be used the week before a PLE or in week 25. So that card is not going to give me anything. So there's no point in me doing that. I do it anyway, it hopefully starts a feud. Right, we got Umbreon here. You can go up against... Who did I put you up against last time? Well, we could do Umbreon on Cammy. Could do a run-in, I suppose. This is... not going well. Okay. Let's make this a triple threat championship match. Let's put Joe Hendry in there as well. World championship match. And we'll do an... Okay, I've got an injury rehab in case Adrian gets injured. Right. This is not going well. This really, really isn't going well. Joe Hendry retains the championship. The rivalry does go to 3 though. That's good. Some North American championship holder you are, Blastoise. Okay, Ashido and Cammy goes to 2. The good thing, because it's going to be WrestleMania, and the last episode now, because we know that I've got the 10 Hall of Fame trophies, it means I can do whatever the fuck I like, and it doesn't matter about injuries at WrestleMania. I could get like 10 injuries, and it won't matter. New champions. Okay, level 2. I've just been really unlucky here. Just some of these rivalries on these promos just haven't taken, and for all means and purposes, they should have done. Mount Lady get, not Mount Lady, Lady Midnight gets the victory. Doesn't increase the rivalry, which is really fucking annoying. No, it isn't, because you're already at level 4. Four, 2.5, 2.5, 4. That's okay. Lula, Tandy and Evie work really well together as a tag team. Good. It only took Evie 3 partners to find one that she worked well with. Yeah, I can't even use that. The week for a PLE is just... ugh. Double cost. Yeah, that's fine. Good luck with that. Pierce on 3 trophies ahead of you. Yeah, you can have 50k if that's what you want, Triton. Fine. Lula and Donna. In the next 3 weeks? Sure. I can do that. I'm not going to, but I can. Because I've got 2 weeks left of the season. So if that makes your morale happy, then fine. Right, let's get those. Power cards, Superstar GM, Forged in Fire. There we go. Should we just go Scorched Earth? Let's get a court. Okay, so we're going to have a Hell in a Cell next week. Yeah, I can't use that, never mind. A casting match, a TLC, a special guest, Superstar GM. Right, who are we going to cheer up? Let's cheer up. Right, you're in a level 4 feud, so let's cheer you up. There we go. Right. Okay. So we're going to need call-outs. Okay. We're going to have Dwaggie call out Adrian. That should hopefully get that up to level 4. We're going to have... the women's tag can go at each other. In a match, Cammy and Mina can call each other out. Or 33 and 59. What if I do a double call out for the tag team championships instead? That's what I'm gonna do. With any luck, that can go to level 4. Right. Arcus and Blastoise are going to go into a match. What's the one that gives a chance for a double rivalry chance? Submission. Okay, we'll put them in a submission match. We'll make it for a title. That, you know what? That can be the main event going into the pay-per-view. Right. I should probably put the men's tag up in a match. They've got stamina, so that's fine. So we'll make that a title match. Why not? Right. Karen Compactor. We're going to put you in a submission match as well in an attempt to make it level 3 rivalry. Okay, let's make this a tables match. And then we'll do a fatal four-way between these two to try and get that rivalry up as well. So this is me trying to build all the rivalries up as high as I possibly can for the pay-per-view. Right. Here we go. Men's tag. New champions. Okay, level 4. Okay. Fantastic. Right. Right, Argus the Great and Blastoise in a submission match. I'm hoping it will increase the rivalry to level 3. Level 2 only. Okay. That's disappointing, but okay. Okay, women's tag goes to level 3. Brigatito gets the victory. Neither of the rivalries increase. Okay, tag team rivalry goes to level 4. Submission match. Karen, Compatra and Leafeon. Karen gets the victory. Goes to level 2. Neither of the submission match boosted. That's frustrating. Okay, so this is going to be the last ever show that I do on WWE 2K24, because literally this is the hardest challenge and I'm going to successfully do it. I should probably check. Cars get running. Okay. Right. Okay, Mania. Double cost, yeah, fuck you. No, it's you're in a level 4 feud, Hitman-chan, and it's WrestleMania. Deal with it. You are welcome. Right. Show logistics. Oh, we can... Holy shit, we can add a boost. I wasn't aware that state-of-the-art effects could actually be boosted. Huh. The more you know. I literally didn't know that that was possible. Manage roster. Right, so we've got a perk somewhere. Hitman-chan. No, I don't want to fire. No. Doesn't fucking matter now, does it? It's the last freaking season. Last show I ever do. There can only be one. Right. Get schooled. Pre-match physio. Right. Get schooled can go on to... Is there anyone who's close to getting a new perk? I think Umbreon's the closest. I don't think 5 XP is going to do the job, though. Oh, it did. Only just, but it did. Okay, Umbreon, what's your new perk? Submission or Steel Cage? Let's give you Steel Cage. Right, okay. So, we need a Hell in a Cell match. So, right. Right, let's get all the championship matches just at where they should be. Right, so it's going to be Joe Hendry, Dwaggie, Adrian Williams. And... yeah, it's just going to be a triple threat. And we'll make that a Hell in a Cell match for the title. Right, so that's that. Right, then we want a casket match. Karen and Leafeon, that's what we're going to have the casket match for. Title match. That is going to be the main event, no matter what. Right, casket match. Then, we're going... oh, does that card actually increase the quality as well? No, it just prevents the talent from being fired. Okay, right. We're going to have a special guest referee match. I'm not quite sure. Does that have to be a singles or can that be a double? No, it does have to be a singles. Okay, right. Let's put in Cinnamon Garrett versus Midnight. And it's going to be a special guest match. And we're going to have Sprigatito be aligned to Midnight, I'd say. Right, then we're going to have the men's tag. And that, we'll just leave that there just for a second. That is going to be a TLC match, probably. Why did I put TLC? And it's a branded pay-per-view bonus as well. Do any of them have a TLC speciality? Two of them do. Okay, you know what? That's going to go there. That's going to go there. We need the women's tag as well, don't we? Okay. Backstage brawl. Last man standing match is one that we could do. Well, I've got five different specialities there, don't I? So, okay. I did say I wanted an ambulance match, didn't I? Hang on, don't I have an ambulance match card? I thought I did. I could have sworn I had an ambulance match card. Right, you know what? Let's lob Argus the Grey in there as well. Might as well just do charity promos since it is going to be the last ones that we ever do. So charity on you. Okay, you know what? No. I've changed my mind. Who are you in a feud with? Sprigatito. Right, here's what we're going to do. We're going to clear this. We're going to have this as a Fatal 4-Way Falls Count Anywhere match. And we're going to put Sprigatito and Espeon in there, but we'll put them in there just as a placeholder. Right, Espeon. It means we have wasted a card, but it doesn't matter. We're trying to get all these rivalries done as much as possible. We have Cammy and Argus in there as well. We need it for the title. Shall I come put Fatal 5-Way? And if we get rid of the casket match card, we could turn it into a backstage brawl for the title. We could put Cammy and Mina in there. Where's Cammy? Right, clear that. Well, that does give us two backstage brawl back to back. We don't want that, really, do we? Falls Count Anywhere. Do I have an FCA? I have an FCA. We have a Hell in a Cell. Okay, let's make that one a steel cage then. Two backstage. Okay, no. That one should be a backstage brawl because we've got two people who've got that boost. Right. So this one. Two tables, TLC. Does give a very low boost though, doesn't it? We have that as a... Okay, we have that as a tables. Right, we'll switch that around. Put that there. Okay, and that leaves us charity promos for these. Quinby, you can come in and just do a charity promo for us. Right, that's the card. This could literally go absolutely anywhere. I could book a GM interference as well. Hang on, if I book a GM interference... Normal match type. Okay, that's a waste then. Okay, we'll just do that. This is our final ever show. Okay, so starting off, Joe Hendry, Dwaggienite, Adrian Williams, and Argus the Great in a Hell in a Cell Fatal 4-Way match for the NXT World Championship. Joe Hendry is still your NXT World Heavyweight Championship. Say his name. Believe in Joe Hendry. We believe in Joe Hendry. Blast Source cuts an embarrassing promo, but still gets the 750 fans. So that's all right. I had no place in the card for the Intercontinental, the North American Championship, because it was only a level 2 feud. Falls Count Anywhere, Fatal 4-Way, a double rivalry here. Cinnamon Garrett gets the win. 4 star. Trey Primer gets a 6,750. TLC for the Men's NXT Tag Team Championships. The heels get it. Triton and Hitman-chan. 5 star. Triton injured for 3 weeks, but it doesn't matter. It's the end of the season. Dawn Blitz gets us 6,000 fans.
Hello.
Next up, a tables tag team championship match for the women's tag team championships. Look at Tandy and Evie beat the Doms. 4 stars. Charity Private Quinby gets us 3,750 fans. Not bad for $18,000. Like $12,000 cost for the charity and $6,000 or whatever it was to employ her. Now, a fatal four-way backstage brawl match for the NXT Women's Championship. Leafeon is good with wood, apparently. She is the world champion. Four and a half. Completely blasted all the other pay-per-views out of the water, as you would expect. 367,000 fans, $38,000 profit, show quality 28 out of 30, match card quality 104 out of 120, superstar level bonuses 25, show bonuses plus 2. Crowd are seeing the social media saying mayhem out there on tonight. Leafeon and Karen both picking up injuries. Show of the year, maybe even of the decade. Holy crap, Leafeon finally won a match. Karen and Leafeon are both fantastic at backstage brawl matches. And we have successfully done the impossible challenge. Jobbers only, extreme difficulty, extreme AI, and going against 3 AI players. There is nothing left for me to do. I've done the hardest possible challenge on MyGM on 2K24. We've literally done the hardest thing that anybody has ever thought of. We've absolutely smashed it. We've literally done the hardest thing in MyGM that anybody has ever thought of. Our final champions, Joe Hendry, the prestigious one, the answer, the local hero. Say his name and he appeared. Joe Hendry is our NXT champion. Meanwhile, on the ladies' side, Leafeon, having many, many table and backstage brawl matches, ends up being the women's champion at the end of season 4. There you are, a full Hall of Fame. We've done it, ladies and gentlemen, jobbers only. We have literally done it. We've literally done it. Jobbers only. And that is where we retire from WWE 2K24. It's been a journey. I hope everybody has enjoyed all of the content that I've produced for WWE 2K24, especially for the MyGM mode. We'll be back next year for 2K25, which, depending on when it releases, it'll either be the end of this year or maybe March 2025. But we've done it. We have literally done the hardest challenge. And I'd say it was actually pretty easy. We had some issues. We had our good old booking book of booking here. But we got it done. Thank you everybody for watching. It has been an honour to perform for you for this. Thank you very much for watching. And if you want more of this content, let me know in the video description. I guess I'll turn on comments just for this video. But I do intend to come back, as I said, for 2K25, assuming my GM mode is still in that mode. And I cannot wait to see what they bring in next year. Maybe they'll allow us to have like 8-person matches or something. Or, cross my fingers, asynchronous multiplayer. Let us play online against our friends in my GM mode. Please give us that 2K. Please give us that. I need that. I need hook it into my veins. I need it. Thank you everybody for watching.